introduction. It's great to be speaking before the B2B here in Crystal Lake. takes a lot of motivation to stay motivated. But I think I have stumbled upon something that can help us all. It is a book. This book right here. This is called Get Clients Now, a 28-day marketing program for professionals and consultants. And according to this book, the number one way to get yourself motivated and to keep motivated is to exercise daily. Now, ideally, an hour a day. Now, of course, you can't just walk into any old gym and start lifting weights willy-nilly. You got to do some research. So for the past 28 days, I've been researching health clubs. My methods are pretty simple. I get up pretty early, you know, around 10 or 11 in the morning. What I usually do is I grab the yellow pages and my cell phone and I head on down to the office. Now, a lot of people call it McDonald's. I prefer the term office. Sounds a little more professional. Another way to get yourself motivated and to keep yourself motivated, according to the book, is to listen to motivational tapes while you're driving. Now, I couldn't agree with that more. It works for me. In fact, I have a set of 12 8-track tapes that I listen to over and over and over again while I'm driving, and they're really great. Except that, you know, it takes about 6 hours of driving to get through all those tapes. In fact, on my way into work a few times, I've had to call in sick because I haven't finished listening to all my tapes yet. Now, another thing that the experts tell me is, if I want to be good at this speaking business, I got to have a book. I got to have a book. And that kind of holds true for everything you do in life, right? You want to be a truck driver, you got to have a book. So really important to have a book if you want to be a speaker, and I couldn't agree with that more. In fact, I'm writing a book. I am. Now, the working title is Daily Inspirations for People Fed Up with Daily Inspirations. That's kind of the launching pad. I don't know if we'll keep that title, but close. So I'm writing the book. Actually, I haven't written a darn word yet, but I am working on a book, and I'm really proud of that. But again, you know, you can't just jump into writing a book. You gotta think it through. You gotta plan. In fact, the experts say you gotta have a plan and a vision for your book. You gotta have a plan and a vision for your book. Can you say that with me? You gotta have a plan and a vision. For your book. Yeah, your very book. Good, very good. Thank you, Michelle, for that. For your book. For your book. And actually, anything in life, you got to have a plan and a vision,
strategy,
right?
Strategy, too.
Strategy, very good. I write the jokes here, Michelle. Not you. Okay, so I've been thinking a lot about my plan, really thinking about it. And as they say in sales, you got to plan your work and work your plan and plan on working on your plan. Because without a plan, you have no plan to work on. And I plan on having a good, workable plan that I can work on. I just haven't gotten around yet to planning the plan, but I'm working on that. Above and beyond the plan and the vision really for the book, if you really want to be a writer, folks, you got to have a place to write. Am I right about that? You got to have a place to write. I mean, Steinbeck, Hemingway, F. Scott Fitzgerald, they all had places to write. And so with that in mind, if you're going to be a writer, I've been down at the lumber yard looking for wood for the desk that I plan to build. that's really important. And this is going to be a solid writer's desk. It's not going to be one of those flimsy pieces of plywood on a couple of sawhorses. You know, would Hemingway use a piece of plywood? I don't think so. And then there's the lighting. Don't even get me started on the lighting. Did you know that there's like a whole slew of lighting experts in the Yellow Pages? I went through this, I spent 28 days just researching these lighting experts. In fact, I have a consultation with one after this at my house. She's going to come in and just figure out the perfect kind of lighting for my writer's desk, because lighting and writing, they're like this. They go together like this. You can't have one without the other. You can have lighting without writing. I mean, we have a room here with lighting and no writing, right? Except for probably the guy in the back texting going, this guy sucks, when's this gonna be over?